We're in the semifinals of the Country Boys competition. Matthew Essick and Zack Watson on the left and right respectively have to win this to get to right to meet Danny Huneycutt in the final. And Matthew opens with a super shot. Zack trickles by. It's about 8:15 Sunday morning. Sun's coming up on our right. Matthew changed his mind. And Zack hits it. It actually is this quiet this morning once the lawnmowers left. This format is a kind of double elimination. Danny Huneycutt won the winner's side of the draw. Each of these guys has one loss. Zack lost to Danny. Matthew lost to Mike Taylor. Matthew's been on a roll ever since, though. I think Zack Watson, is about 29 years old, and Matthew, of course, is 17. That bandana in Zach's belt is the flag of the Country Boys tournament, which is what you're watching. tables have turned. And Matthew has partner at the peg, nicely rushable to hoop one. The ball is for four back. Thank you. Danny, waiting to see who wins this game, so he gets to play them for the final. Obviously, Zack rushed up here to get these balls. Perfect black. Looks like Matthew's thinking about a TPO. And he stops three again with blue. Interesting. While we wait for Zack, a little bit of the scenery here in North Carolina. Thank you. So Matthew remains on hoop three with blue and hoop one with black. Zack is on four back with yellow and one with red. Either ball. Matthew, Danny, and Brian Cummings looking on. And there's Becky Essick, who's Matthew's grandmother. Steve Summers, our gracious host. Rick Shealy, Joe Yoder, and Mike Taylor. All the early morning crowd. Going out. Oh my goodness. It is for hoop two. This is going to be interesting because his pioneer at four is on the south boundary. Let's see how he copes with that. The first peel is done, but he can't get a good rush on black. I'm not sure he can even hit it. From his body language, I guess he can't even hit it. The scatter shot. Okay, so the red clip is on four, the yellow clip is on penult, blue is on three, and black is still on one. Maybe the third time will be charmed. deciding out for the death roll on the penultimate peel of opponent. Rush peel it. Goodness, he's going to try a Wiley transit peel on the opponent ball. So if he's going to peel hoop one, maybe he's planning on pegging out both balls. Can't do the Wiley without an escape ball. does peg out both balls, it'll be a one-ball game with Matthew at 2 and Zack at 4. Maybe it'll be 2-1. We'll see. Thank you. That's a revolting development. Keeps the interactivity level high. So, Matthew's on two with black and the peg with blue. Zack is on four with red and the peg with yellow. The attempted peg out on opponent having failed. Fortunately, he didn't accidentally peg himself out. And again, blue is his peg ball. Let's see if he rushes yellow to the peg and tries again to peg it out. Should be easier this time. I'm pretty sure they're playing without a time limit. So it's a one ball, red for four, black for two. Into the jaws. Taking no chances. Thank you. red overrolled a little. Didn't want to take that shot for obvious reasons. Wired from red, he's responsible for his own position. Red can't afford to set up. Has to bail. Guaranteed position for a long roll after the hoop. Yeah, they're both for hoop six. Knowing the advantage of being further from the hoop in this situation, Matthew goes out about level with four back. This is Zach's response. North boundary. I don't know when we start thinking about impasse, but we're working on it. He's back. Westbound. Come on, guys. Okay, here we go. They're both still for one back.
Thank you.
clarified the rule and then came back and croqueted black. Clarifying the list situation. And having rolled black up near two back, he elected to hit back out to the west boundary. Two wired position, and Matthew does get a lift for wiring. Now they're both at the same hoop, but Zack does get a lift. Eastbound. So, red's for four back, black is for penult. And here comes the shot. Not by much. And it's over. They even decided not to bother with the peg out. So, Matthew Essick over Zack Watson. 26-23 in a one ball game. Matthew now gets to play Danny Huneycutt. Best 2 out of 3 for the Country Boys final. And Danny's getting warmed up. I'm going to watch that one. You can read about it in the newspaper. One last shot of the peanut gallery. Steve Summers' beautiful facility in Winston Salem, North Carolina.